A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Lego Star Wars The Complete Saga, everyone. Oh, wait. There you go. Welcome, guys, to another brand new walkthrough on Lego Star Wars The Complete Saga. This will also be a part of, like I said last time on Batman Arkham Knight, this will be a part of the journey to the Road to Skywalker Saga. Well, the Road to the Skywalker Saga. But let's take a quick look at the intro first. Of course, this is by far the greatest game that has ever been known. I'm sorry. Man, the graphics of this game are so cool. Okay. I guess a lot of people got freaked out by this. When they chopped C-3PO's head off, I'm like, oh no! To me, this is by far the greatest LEGO Star Wars game that TT Games had ever invented. Because it shows how they cared about the original trilogy, the sequel, well, actually the prequels. Now, I know a lot of you may be thinking, oh, but the sequels are so bad. Well, to me, they're fine. They're okay. But anyways, guys, we're going to start off a brand new game. So without further ado, let us get started. So we have Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan Kenobi. Alright guys, here we are in the hub world of LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. We're in the Mos Eisley Cantina where the original, where LEGO Star Wars The Original Trilogy was hubbed at. Now, of course, if you come back outside, well, you can't actually, destroy these guys, which is kind of weird. Maybe they're invincible. But anyways, guys, here we are at the outside, which is, well, we're currently at Tatooine. But as you may notice, here at the outside, we have a door. These are called the Bounty Hunter missions. You need to unlock at least, several characters in order to actually unlock that doorway. We're going to try 100% complete this game, but I will not make any promises. This is a game to the Road of the Skywalker saga. Okay, now I'm just saying things out of place. But here we have the shop. Here we have some hints, characters, extras, extra code, called bricks, and clips we can watch. I don't know who that guy is. Of course, Jedi characters can also use the Force. So whenever you see a Force object, you'll be able to use it. Now this right here is the bonus room. This is where all the bonus levels will be located at. We don't see anything yet because we haven't gotten into the story yet. Right here are the trailers. We have the intro, and guess who we can get here? LucasArts. Meet our new Harrison Ford character.
The world's most sought after treasures. He has become known as the greatest adventure hero of all time. But next year...
Ow.
Adventure breaks new ground.
Yep. LEGO Indiana Jones, everyone. We will also be doing a playthrough of that to the Skywalker Saga as well once we're done. Want to do? Want a ducky?
From the award-winning creators of LEGO Star Wars, Indiana Jones films in one ultimate game. Play as the legendary action hero in Lego Indiana Jones, the video game. The greatest adventure ever assembled.
Coming summer 2008. Good thing I already have the game. Now, of course, guys, here, in order to unlock Indiana Jones, you need to at least watch the trailer for that. Indiana Jones is now available to buy in the shop. And now, in LEGO Indiana Jones, you can unlock Han Solo in that game. Because, well, Han Solo is Indiana Jones, because they're both the same actor. Now, of course, for Indiana Jones, the way how it was made, it was made with the help of George Lucas as well. Of course, it was made by Lucasfilm as well. In order to unlock Han Solo in the LEGO Indiana Jones video game, you need to find at least 5 of the original trilogy Star Wars characters, which are Luke, Leia, and who else? Luke, Leia, Chewbacca, C-3PO, and R2-D2. Those are the 5 Star Wars characters that you need to find in LEGO Indiana Jones. They are everywhere in the 3 episodes in that game. But here we are, guys. Here we are in the Phantom Menace, and we have a LEGO build up here. So without further ado, guys, let's get started with Chapter 1. The negotiations were short. Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Chapter 1, Negotiations. Turmoil has engulfed the Galactic Republic. With a blockade of deadly battleships, the Trade Federation has stopped all shipping to the small planet of Naboo. The Supreme Chancellor has secretly dispatched Jedi Knights, Qui-Gon Jinn, and Obi-Wan Kenobi to settle this conflict. Silver C-3PO. Well, that was anticlimactic. Hold B to use the force on glowing objects. So on glowing objects, you can use the force to actually move them. We're going to try 100% this game as best as we can, everyone. I won't make any promises, but as I said before, you know, Road to Skywalker stuff. I love that tune, man. Battle droids. Walk up to a friendly character and press Y to control them. So of course, Obi-Wan Kenobi has... Okay, I'm so sorry everyone. But anyways... sorry. Whew. Man, talking like this just gets me exhausted. But each Jedi has a different set of, well, fighting styles. So, of course, Obi-Wan Kenobi has the blue lightsaber, Qui-Gon Jinn has the green lightsaber. I won't be sticking around with the same character every now and then, because, you know, it just gets boring. Now, there are two minikits we can easily get here. Now, the way out to easily find minikits is you need to listen to this. You hear that? That's the sound of a minikit nearby. There's a minikit that's right here waiting for us. All you gotta do is just flip up these switches. Voila! You get your first minikit. When I first found minikits, now... Well, first, let me tell you something. You're probably wondering what a minikit is. Basically, it's a canister that holds a Lego piece. Oh, look at that, we got a power-up. Now, power-ups, they can be found everywhere in objects and in enemies. Or just lying across around the field. Basically, what this power-up does, it grants you invincibility, and for Jedi, it'll grant you purple force and the purple lightsaber. But it only goes for a limited time. So it doesn't stay like that forever. We have TC-114, another protocol droid. Droids can operate Lego panels. Press B to activate. Of course, guys, just like what I said before, I will also be doing a playthrough on Lego Star Wars The Force Awakens. I don't think I actually said that before. I meant to say Lego Indiana Jones and Lego Star Wars The Force Awakens once we're done with that one. The PS5 actually comes in a few days, actually. Because Spider-Man PS4 is a game that I really want to play for you guys. You were right about one thing, Master. The negotiations were short. Oh no! I was gonna get the minikit, but I jumped down. I love the... whenever you... hold on, let's try this out on enemy. When you ever do this... it powers up the strike of your attack. Whenever you press XXX slowly, it powers up the attack, which is pretty cool. Monster, destroy this! Basically, the easy way to take down droids is you basically need to do a Jedi Slam or do a powerful attack like this, and it'll destroy the shield. I need to get ourselves up here. We just completed the first level. This is what I really love about the Lego games. They make very funny animations. I think that's why the old games are better than the new ones, because they make much more better jokes in that one. But to be honest, the jokes in all Lego games, they're all kidding me. Besides, I grew up playing with Lego, to be honest with you guys. And I gotta be honest with you, playing with Lego was actually pretty fun for me when I was little. I still do it, even though then I pass up the time on, you know, whenever I get bored. All episodes are now unlocked, so once you complete the first level, you unlock all the episodes. But we're gonna continue the story, so let's continue. New save data. Chapter 2, Invasion of Naboo. The Trade Federation has launched a full-scale attack on the peaceful world of Naboo. Hiding aboard the landing craft, Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan Kenobi have secretly hitched a ride with the invasion force. Now they must make contact with local forces before it is too late. Then let's get to it. Man, I love the original Lego games. Don't you mean oof? Alright, let's go. Now, of course, under these planes, you'll find, well, these things, a walkie-talkie. Got the guy on the speeder bike. Alright, we need to overload the generator. Gotta blow this up. Got it! I got to kill the Gungan. Jar Jar, get down! It wasn't even moving that fast. Get off of me. Alright, let's follow you, Jar Jar. Wonder where we're going. Alright guys, so here is Jar Jar, one of the least popular characters in the game. Or in the Star Wars series. Now of course, what Jar Jar is really helpful for, even though he's really annoying, is that he'll be able to jump very high, which makes him a very important character. So of course we're going to need Jar Jar's help to actually navigate this area. Of course guys, I have watched the behind the scenes stuff with, you know, Star Wars and all, with the Phantom Menace. It took a really long while to make, if I recall. They actually had to, from what I learned from the Ural All Knights channel, is that in the original trilogy for Star Wars A New Hope, they had to actually film at least part of the movie in space. In actual space. Crazy, huh? I sort of thought filming a film was ever difficult. I'm not sure if that's the right way to put it. Like, you know what? Forget it. Make it. Now, of course, that hatch right there, it may seem like just like a simple, you know, hatch attack. It may seem like a little Lego piece attached to the wall, but it's actually a little small hatch for small characters to go through. I really love the water effect and everything in this game. It really expressed how the original stuff used to actually... it expresses how TT Games used to make their games. They should have kept making these things like this. I love the original trilogy stuff. Because it shows how much compassion they put into this game. I love the effects of it. Alright, we need Jar Jar to get this door open. To get this mini kit right here, you need to put this statue back together. Wow, 7 mini kits, not bad. When we come back here, we just need 3 more to go. Alright, let's go in. Hope you're in your bathrobes. You shall let us go. Did you see that Qui-Gon Jinn did a sweet mind trick on him? We got Jar Jar Binks. Binksy. I guess we can do one more level before we, we can do one more level. Sorry if I skipped that, but it's just, we need to go a little bit faster. Here we are. All right, let's do this. Obi-Wan, is your lightsaber not working? There you go. Aw, but you missed all the fun. You missed all the fun. Okay. And what's weird about this level is that you don't play as Jar Jar in this one. That's kind of weird. But here we are, guys. We are in Naboo. We have Queen Amidala and Captain Panica. Grapple up here. Punch him. Yeah, when you get close and personal with them, when you're not like, you know, a Jedi character, then you punch them straight in the face. Thank you. Jackson of the Minikin. Actually, we're gonna try to see if we can get the full level. I mean, the full episode here. Just once. What's down here? Whoa! And I'm dead! Oh, look at that, a minikit. I really love the classic minikits. What they did with them in the future? Eh. I mean, some of them are still the same, they just need some work. Do we need to shoot that target? There we go. Oh, I heard some lightsabers. There they are. Wait, where's Jar Jar? Oh, you miss. Where's Jar Jar? Which button does that press? Alright, we're almost out of here. That's not it. Found it! Let's go! What are you doing?
Roger, Roger.
Surprise! Whoa, shiny. Let's take it. Level completed. We'll do one full episode and then we'll do the rest, like, we'll do the rest in parts. That's what we'll do. Mos Espa Padres. Queen Amidala and her Jedi protectors have fled Naboo, heading for Coruscant. They plan to inform the Galactic Senate of the Trade Federation invasion. However, the Royal Starship's hyperdrive is damaged in the escape, and they have been forced to land on the remote planet of Tatooine for repairs, where they meet Anakin Skywalker. The the chosen one. Oh no, you broke it. Oh, I don't know what I did. I love this game. People going like, oh, another hyperdrive. $500? Winning a pod race will earn you $500. Wait, there's two Anakins. Oh my god, there's a bunch of them. Alright guys, here we are in our first pod race. Let's go! So, the controls are pretty simple. It's like Mario Kart, or Team Sonic Racing for that matter. Or Angry Birds Go before it got, you know, deleted. Whoa! Just gotta avoid the obstacles and get past these guys. And get first place. Make it! Tusken Raiders. Yeah, you gotta be careful around here because Tusken Raiders are gonna be coming in and out shooting at you. Oh, shoot, I got shot. Oh, you didn't make it. Oh! There is a different version of this pod race, however, you are on a time limit on some areas, which pretty much sucks. Oh god, rocks. Rocks, 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 rocks. Oh, I hit this guy. I'm gonna hit it back. True Jedi! This pod race tends to be easier. Alright, we're on the final lap. One more minikit. Wow, we got them all. I'm catching up to Sepulba. Gotta keep going. Goes there too. Oh, okay, that was easy. Awesome. Oops, they just ran straight to the wall. Anakin's pod. This can also be flown up in like other places like space. Pretty weird, huh? Oh, we almost got that one down. G
Chapter 5. Retake Thief Palace. On Coruscant, Queen Amidala has found the Galactic Senate corrupt by Trade Federation influence and mirrored and imbued in bureaucracy. Frustrated, she has returned home to Naboo, together with Qui-Gon Jinn, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Captain Panaka, R2-D2, and young pod racer from Tatooine, Anakin Skywalker. Queen Amidala now plans to infiltrate the royal palace and capture the evil Trade Federation Viceroy. There we go. So it didn't work out with the Galactic Senate. Yeah, we got it. Huh. Padme's changed her hair. And her skin. Creepy. Uh-oh. It's just like the movies. R2-D2 has the ability to hover. This goes for all astromech droids. Small characters can crawl through access hatches. Press B to do this. Hey, he can do it. Studs. Why am I typing? Alright, so let's get this door open. Huh, what do you know? I had it right. So this is Padme in her battle suit. Of course, she is actually the Queen of Naboo herself. She just has a stunt double doing the job. I can't get up. Now these lamps, for stuff that glows red, they require the dark side of the Force to actually work. We don't have that yet. Oh, that's cool! I can't wait to move to the new trilogy. I mean, the old trilogy, that one's much more colorful. This game just trying to charge into enemies. Oh, I didn't want to force push R2. Oh, now that's cool. Rainbow bubbles. Hold on, there's a minikit that I want to get here. Well, you know, a secret passageway. Alright, we need to get down there. The button's over there. Alright, let's get Anakin over there. I think with this footage, this makes the complete saga much more better. Since this is an old school game, don't get me wrong, an old school game, but sometimes they're much more fun when you play them in the new era. There, we just need to get ourselves up here. There is a red brick in here that I want to grab. I think I'm saying grab the wrong way. I keep saying grab instead of grab. And I'm dead, great. I talk about some things and then I die. They still keep the classic studs and not add new ones. Ah, oh, I died just punching Obi-Wan in the face. Looks like we gotta rescue some guards. And it's this vehicle right here. I think this is one of the best vehicles in the game besides, you know, cars and stuff. Because it's like a hoverboard, but just in a car way. Two guards rescued. And look, it's these Naboo ships. We also get these in the game as well, once you complete the bonus level of it. Oh, here comes some more. I'm trying to get through the levels fast as I can, we're dying. Alright, we need R2 for this. Thank you.
Man, I got lightsaber bars working. It's no use.
Huh?
Wow. Hey, got him. One more level, guys. Super slap. Yeah, some of these extras are pretty weird. Alright guys, one more level. And that is episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Chapter 6. Darth Maul.
The Trade Federation Army has been neutralized by Anakin Skywalker, but the battle continues in the Royal Palace. Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan Kenobi have one more enemy to face.
Hello there.
What is that? Boop, boop, boop. Oh!
Alright guys, here we are fighting off against Darth Maul. Now Darth Maul, for the first phase of the fight, he'll send in his battle droids to do the work for him. After you take care of them, he's gonna use the Force to knock some explosives over to us. Right here, we also have some battle droids here. You can battle any lightsaber enemy that's here in the game with any character that has a lightsaber. Especially your own custom character. Oh my god, did you see that? Where are you going, Maul? Now you just gotta chase him down. But also guys, if you are enjoying the Let's Play so far, feel free to comment down below, give this video a like, and if you like what you see, consider subscribing. Oh yeah, there's another one here. Come back here. There he is. Oh yeah, I forgot those guys can call him back up.
Roger, roger.
Better act fast.
You can actually write up these weird beams right here. Oh, did you see that? I think I pulled a muscle on my foot right there. Yeah, if you keep dealing with the battle droids that the command battle droids keep taking out, I mean, they'll keep calling them in. I'm pretty sure I said most of that wrong. Both died. Jordy cuss. Now we get to the real fight. So right here in the center of the power core room is a big endless hole. And if you jump down in it, it's instant death.
Eat this bike of yours. Man, you're just making mini kids appear and appear. Oh, there goes my lightsaber. Oh, gotcha.
See ya, Maul.
And he's dead. To the X's. No.
That's what I love about these games. They always have the X's in them.
Because whenever characters die in this one, they have the X sign. It's like, dead. Alright, let's finish the story.
And there we go, guys. That is it for The Phantom Menace, Episode 1. Which was the trilogy. The first trilogy episode ever made by Lucasfilms.
But anyways, guys, that is it for this episode. We did our first 1 hour episode for the Road to the Skywalker Saga. But anyways, guys, thank you all so much for watching. In the next episode, we're going to start off with Episode 2, Attack of the Clones. Anyways, guys, thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.